Okay, so yesterday we talked about the basics of how you're going to determine what type of graph you're going to have, and it's based on the data. So if you have continuous by continuous data, you're going to do a line graph or a scatter plot. If we got categorical on the x-axis and continuous on the y-axis, then we're going for a bar graph. So yesterday we went through the example of example A, and we had the line graph going there, and then some of the other examples that we did and practice ones we did were all line graphs. So let's go and look at example B and figure out how we're going to do this bar graph, okay? So here's what I want you to do. I want you to go ahead and read through example B with your partner right now, and then we'll stop and we'll go back and we'll take a look at it. You ready? Go.
Students want to determine how different colors of light affect the growth of plants.
They're back.
Centimeters
on the All
right. Students want to determine how different colors of
light. The color.
Colors of light, red, green, white. Very good.
Does she want us to do it?
Okay, you ready? They're going to be filling in. As we fill in, just grab them and let them know what we're doing, okay? All right, so here's what we're going to do. I know you guys have the graph paper, so here's what it's on the back of the sheet. So I think what we'll do is, if you can remember to do this, let's pull that back sheet off and just staple it on later again so we can deal with this. And then, Brittany, can you close that door? Oh, let's grab a couple rulers. Does everybody have a ruler? Pass back some. Julie, are you fresh? Okay, we good to go? Pass the rulers back. Don't pass the whole bucket. Yeah, just do it that way. All right, so watch. The rules are the same. You're still going to do independent variables on the x-axis. Just file in, fill in. There they go. We're still going to do... Listen, please. We're still going to do independent variable on the x-axis, dependent variable on the y-axis, okay? So let's go ahead, and what's our independent variable going to be?
Colors
of light. So let's label our axis, colors of light. So we still have a 15 by 15 grid, just like we had yesterday. So there's a couple rules that you want to make sure you go with this, okay? So you want to occupy the whole stretch on here, okay? So because we have 15 and we have three different types of three different bars that we're going to make, you can go in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You start a bar there, go over another 5, 2, 4, 5, make another bar there, and you can take this one to here, okay? However, here's where the tweak is. If you happen to have 4 or you happen to have 5 or whatever it is, make it fit the best you can, okay? What I don't want to see is this. You see a bar like this, and then a bar like this, and then a bar like this, and then you have this gap. You want to try and spread it out as evenly as possible within reason. So if it doesn't fit perfectly or doesn't go in perfectly, that's fine. But if you have four, you can go in and go, all right, we have 4, so let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's go right to the halfway point, right? And then take half of that. So you go 1, 2, 3. We got 1, 2, 3. About right here in the middle of this, and just split the differences and make your bars like that. You could do, let's go 3 wide, leave a gap here, 3 wide, leave a gap here, 3 wide, leave a gap here, and then 3 wide, I'd be okay with that. That would probably work better with a 15 by 15. Just make it work, okay? And then once you get that, make your bars and develop them off that, okay? So for this one, I'll show you, those are like the rules that you wouldn't see you would see them from like different examples, okay? So let's go ahead, and we know we have 3, so let's go ahead and go 5 out. So we'll do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Basically what I do is put a little mark there, so I'm going to start a line there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make a little mark there, and those are where my bar widths are going to be, okay? Some teachers tell you, when you had weeks, did he tell you don't let the bars touch? Sometimes it doesn't matter. You see it in every graph they touch. So, and I'll show you a couple other tricks that'll make it go really fast. Essentially, you can show me any graph and I'll have it done in less than 3 minutes. I can just, I've done it over and over again. Yes, I've practiced, but I can show you, I just don't need another tricks, okay? So we have our colors. So what I'm gonna do is, you can color the bar, but then we have to add a key on the side that says red equals this, blue equals this, and so forth. But you can also label it in the bottom. So I'm gonna make a little bar halfway below it, or between it, and I'm gonna label off my different colors. So I'm gonna put red right here, right in the middle of this one. I'm gonna put green, and then this one I'm gonna put white. So far, so good? Okay. Now, the next thing I'm gonna do is, let's do the dependent variable. So we have growth of plants. So I'm gonna go on the y-axis, growth of plants. Make sure you put your units in. We have centimeters per week. And then, let's go back to our values, okay? Lowest value is 1.2, so we gotta go from 1 to about 6. All right, that's the stretch we have to do. But we have 15 increments. So, what we could do is, talk with your partner, see if you can figure it out. This is my first time through. We have 15 increments, and we have to fit it between 1 and 6, basically. Talk to your partner, see how you can break it up. Go. I'll come up with my own. More seconds. Ten more seconds. You, blood's here. Hey, good morning. All right. So could we do 0 to 15? What's the problem with that? You're going to have very small bars, and it's going to be kind of stupid. You're going to see, it's like you're going to have all this dead space up here. So you got a weird thing. Okay, so what we could do is this. Watch. What if we did 1 to 6? What's the difference? I mean, what's the difference between 1 and 6? 5. So can we divide 15 by 5? 3. So then we can go every 3. So 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 5. That'll fit in evenly. That's my first time through on that too. So you just got to make it work. Look at the title. So we want to reflect the variables. So we're going to say how light color. I'm just trying to shorten it as much as I can. How light color affects plant growth. That'll work. Okay, so here's the trick on making your bars. You ready? So our first value for red is what? What is it? 3.5. So we're right about in the middle. So watch, I'm gonna follow it out here, and I'm gonna make a dot right here. Value for green is what? 1.2, so it's gonna be about right here. And then white is gonna be 5.1. So we're going to be right in the middle, right about here, okay? Now, once you got those dots in, I use them as guides. When I got the guide in, then I turn it sideways. I know the width of my bar. So I'm just going to make the top portion first. You know you're 5 wide. So I'm going to go from here to here. Follow me on this? Then I got to go from here to here. Then I gotta go from here to here. yesterday. You weren't here, that's right.
Oh, was it the package?
Yeah, the graphing stuff. Yeah, you got it.
Oh, yeah, I got
it. Okay, once you got that done, continue, finish making the uprises. Boom. 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 Now we could convert this into a histogram and try and show, like, we could put green first, red next, and then white to try and show a trend, but we're just trying to figure out which light color works best, okay? When you're done with that, put your pencil down. So, two tricks with this. Technically, you're done. But what does everybody want to do with the bars?
Color
them in, because it's pretty. Okay, whatever. So you don't have to because they're already labeled, that's one. But if it's bugging you, okay, because I know some of you guys are like, I've got to color them in, okay? This looks horrible. When you guys do this. And you just start coloring the whole thing in. This looks like a second grader did it. It's so bad, okay? Let me show you a better way that looks more professional-ish, and it actually goes a lot quicker, okay? Take your ruler, literally just go at, here, just kind of go at an angle, just pick an angle. Here, watch me do it first. I'm gonna go like this, boom. Just move it over a little bit, boom, boom. That's it, three lines. That looks good, right? Ish, it's okay? Guess what I'm gonna do with the next one? Flip my ruler to the other angle, boom. Boom. Done. Guess what I'm gonna do with the last one? Flip it over, and if you want it to look different, just put the increments a little bit tighter. That's it, man. It's easy. I think the biggest time kill on this one is everybody wants to like scribble in the color. It has to be colors. Let me go get colored pencils. That's fine if you want to do it. It's just, I don't think it looks any better. I think it looks kind of crap. So far, so good? Yes, no? Okay, let's go back to our worksheet so we can identify this. So red was our independent variable. So let's label it off so we have these, because we're gonna treat these as notes a little bit later. And it was a categorical data. Growth was our dependent variable. And it was continuous data. So because we have continuous by categorical, we're going to have what type of graph? Do the bar graph. Now, you don't really have correlations with bar graphs. You just don't, because of the nature of it being categorical. It's not like one, the categories don't go up. They don't. But you do have relationships. So I'm going to show you two ways to do the relationships. In general, we're always kind of looking at what's the best, what's the most, what's the highest, correct? Okay, so I'm going to show you one way to do it, but then I can show you the opposite way. This is probably the way you're going to run into it most. The relationship is this, because you have two variables. So which light gives the greatest growth?
The brightest.
Okay, so watch. So this is how I would write it. White light causes the greatest or highest growth. Right? Yeah.
Can you put like the brighter the color, the more growth you get?
But you're trying to fit in that correlation thing, because it's not about brightness, it's about color. It's a color light, and this is actually real. Red is the white light, which has all the colors, gives the most growth. Red is on the it. Plants don't use all light. Ironically, guess what color of light plants don't use for photosynthesis? Green. It doesn't use green. That's why it reflects it off. It uses all the other colors. So it's using those, okay? How could we flip this, though? What's the other answer we could use for this?
Green causes the less.
Green gives the least amount of growth. So you could flip it, but usually you're not like, hey, when you go look on SportsCenter for your teams, you're like, well, who lost today? It's like, who won? You're trying to find the greatest one, okay? So let's do this. Are we good with that? You can hit pause on there.